Congratulations on getting engaged. You and I both know that once you start telling friends and family, one of the first questions you're going to hear is, where are you registered? So before you freak out, don't worry. This is going to be easy and kind of fun because it's almost just like online shopping. We're here to take you step by step and all of the easy tips we have for you on getting started with your wedding registry. First, make a list of what you need. This might be kind of easy for you if you've lived together for a while, but if you're thinking about combining households after you get married, getting started now on seeing what you have duplicates of and seeing what you're missing is a great way to start your move-in together. Make a list so you have some concrete items that you're missing to help start your registry. Next, find your stores. We recommend offering 2 to 3 different options and definitely no more than 4, or it just gets to be a little confusing and it's a little bit more work on your part to go register everywhere. Even though you might love to have gifts only from high-end stores like Dillard's and Crate & Barrel and Pottery Barn, we recommend that you choose a couple of different options that typically offer different price points so that way your guests can shop for you no matter what budget they may be in. So consider shops like Target and Walmart. It also helps if you're thinking about inviting guests from all across the country if you have options that are online as well as brick and mortar stores. Some people just like shopping online because it's super easy and it's fun for you when they ship straight to your home because it's like a surprise Christmas every time you get a package in the mail. This also helps people that might live in areas that don't have as many stores available, and it might not be that they have the stores that you registered at available to them. But there's other guests that are going to want to go to a brick and mortar store, hand pick the item, inspect it for quality, and lovingly wrap it and bring it on the wedding day. So you want to have some options that they can find locally as well. Offer items in multiple different price points. You want to make sure that no matter what your guest budget is, they have an item that they could purchase off of your registry. This means that you need to offer a lot of items as well. So consider registering for more than twice what you actually need. I know that sounds crazy, but you don't want to run out of items on one particular store's registry. One of my favorite items from my wedding was when my maid of honor got me a toilet paper roll holder. That's right, we had barely anything left on our registry list, and that was all she could find that was in her budget. So I have a wonderful, very sentimental toilet paper roll holder from my maid of honor. We should have registered for more things. There's also options to find unique ways to register. So if you're looking for a way to fund your honeymoon or need a little bit of extra cash, you can register through The Knot, Honey Fund, or Zola, and they all house cash options as well. Next, you're gonna wanna spread the shopping out. Just because you think it's fun to look at 30 different patterns of sheet sets before you move on to matching bath towels, doesn't mean that you're not driving your fiance absolutely crazy. Spreading the shopping out can make sure that it's just as fun or at least tolerable for your fiance to choose all of those items. Doing one mega day-long shopping trip ain't gonna work. So it's that easy. Once you register for plenty of stores with multiple items and different price points, you're gonna wanna spread the word about where you're registered at. Our first suggestion, tell your moms. They'll tell everybody. After that, you want to make sure that your registry is listed on all of your bridal shower information as well as your wedding website. For more tips and expert wedding planning advice, follow us on thebridelink.com.